Being a levee inspector requires opening and closing a lot of gates.
My name is Ryan Larson, and we are out here today to do a levee inspection. It looks like we've got some really steep slopes. Concern here is the proximity of that fence line.
There is a pipe through the levee at this location. We want to check the seals, make sure they are not obstructed.
We got a train coming through.
We're at a closure structure for the railroad tracks. Conversations we're having with our sponsor are, have they checked the equipment? That surface protection, that grass is going to be a buffer and prevent erosion of the landside slope of the levee. Trying to give you a perspective of the height of the levee compared to the homes. We care about the public safety and the population inside that levee area. We want to make sure that levees are being operated and maintained in the way they were constructed and provide the best flood risk management benefits when they're tested during the next flood. So let's go do it. So we are out on the upstream side of the American River Flood Control District, about 5 miles north of Sacramento. We're gonna work around in a counterclockwise manner. And this first site that we are at is an encroachment site. One thing of interest is looking at the fence line, and the concern here is that, first of all, the proximity of that fence line to the levee. As a levee inspector, it would be difficult to see in a flood event, you know, with high water, and the fences are really, really close to the toe of the levee, maybe 2 or 3 feet. The next thing we found on our inspection here is a gravity drain, and that gravity drain allows the water that falls inside the levee area, you know, to get through the levee and into the river. So this is the water side end of the gravity drain. There's a trash rack over the top of it, and then we can look down in here and we can see the flap gate. You know, we're starting to see some vegetation creep in here. You know, we want to see that vegetation gets cut back so that we can see this outfall. And let's go check out what's going on at the land side. We're at the landside end of the gravity drain. You got a concrete head wall here, some rebar for making sure trash doesn't get into the pipe. So as water falls into the levee area, comes and collects here at this pipe. And then when the conditions are right, water will move into the channel. Next spot here, we are at a pressurized water line through the levee at a pump station. This is a facility here that collects the rainwater that lands on the streets and people's roofs and comes into this spot to then get pumped up and over the levee and down into the channel. Where this is different than the last stop is that the last one just ran with gravity. Here we have actual pumps, and so the threat there could be internal erosion of the levee.
We're heading on down to the waterside end of the pipe, and we have 4 flap gates.
And it looks like you got a pretty good seal here.
So we're headed out to the closure structure here for the railroad tracks.
You can see here it's about 10 to 12 feet tall, and you can also see down at the bottom of the closure structure there's a sill that would allow us to get a pretty tight seal and to prevent water from moving from the channel on this side into the levee area. And so how this would work is there are closure structure materials that are brought to the site and they're put into place. They work with sandbags and plastic to make sure that there's a tight seal across the bottom of the closure structure, and then build it all up to the appropriate height and make sure that water's not coming through the levee area here. If you look off into the distance, both upstream from here and downstream from here, it's dead right now in this dry season, but you can see the surface protection that's off in the distance. In the rainy season, that would be grass. It would be providing that surface protection. So why that's important is if water were to come over the crown of the levee and to in an overtopping event, you know, that surface protection, that grass is going to be a buffer and prevent erosion of the landside slope of the levee. And we're looking for good surface protection and a good even slope. All right, so we've stopped at another pump station. This one's bigger. It's got many more pipes through the levee. And so we'll go down and take a look at the water side. We're at the water side end of the pipes through the levee. And we got 4 large flap gates, and they all look to be seated up properly against the head wall here. You know, again, with pipes, what we're concerned about is
you know, water from the water side getting back into the levee area. These flap gates help that. And then we're also concerned with the water in that pipe coming through the levee from the pump station. We're concerned about internal erosion. When were the last time the internal condition of those pipes were checked out? So here we want to get a little bit of perspective of what's going on inside the levee area. And we're standing at the crown and we can look down. We're looking down at a single story home, and then off the distance you can also see a two story home and just how tall the levee is compared to those homes. So we're coming to a slope stability observation here. You got the levee off to the right, but you can see this is a really steep slope. And when you have steep slopes, there's a chance for the slopes to become unstable. And we're seeing some evidence of that here. You can see this kind of arc-shaped spot where the slope of this ditch has fallen away or is unstable. This is something that we're going to want to watch and make sure that that instability doesn't come back all the way over here to the levee section. Back to the car. So we've got our last stop here, and we've actually got quite a bit to talk about. The first thing we're going to discuss is this large diameter tree right at the toe of the levee. And so primary concerns is creating a preferential seepage path or a place for water from the water side to find tree roots and then move along those tree roots back to the levee. There are times when a large tree like this could be a problem for operations and maintenance. One of the reasons why this tree is less of a concern is that very recently, the sponsors installed a cutoff wall, a deep cutoff wall on the water side of the flood wall here to cut off potential seepage paths through and under the levee. 40, 50, 60 feet deep in places along the water side of this flood wall. So which brings me to the flood wall. There is a flood wall here to make sure that there is enough height and making sure that the water stays on the water side of the levee. And one of the reasons why they had to build that flood wall, these homes are really close to the levee structure. So there wasn't enough space to build the levee higher and wider because we would have come in contact with these people's backyards and their property. The things that we look at with flood walls, check the surface, the concrete surface of the flood wall, seeing for cracking, spalling, exposed rebar. This one's looking pretty good. Some more of the things we look for are, there's water stops between each section of flood wall, and we're coming up to one right here. We want to look at the integrity of the water stop. So these are here for expansion and contraction of the concrete. And this looks like it's got a pretty good water stop. You want to check the water stop and see if that's a path, you know, a potential path for water to get through the flood wall. All right, so that about wraps it up. I hope you enjoyed our time out here today and hope you learned something. Just to recap some of the things that we saw as we went around this levee system, we saw some encroachments and how to evaluate those. We saw pipes. Different kinds of pipes, gravity drains, and pressurized lines through the levee system. We talked about sod cover and the importance of sod cover on the levee. We saw closure structures with an active train line. We saw some vegetation, evidence of a cutoff wall, and even some flood wall stuff here at the end of the levee system. So appreciate your attention, and we want these levees and flood risk management structures to do the best they can when they're tested during the next flood.